Hey guys, what's up? It's your boy Shaynus. Real quick disclaimer, I lost a lot of footage of this video. This video is the hood install. It got corrupted, and then apparently I think I forgot to record, or I thought I was recording a particular scene at the beginning. So it's gonna be kind of a rough video, but I'm just letting you guys know, you know, so bear with me on that. So now that we got that out of the way, just real quick, sorry for the lack of a video update last week. I've currently been on vacation, hence kind of the scrubbiness. But again, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. This was a mod that's very simple to do, very fast, very easy. It is obviously a little more on the expensive side. But again, major shout out to Josh Leon who hooked it up with this hood. So without further ado, let's just jump straight into it. All right, so real quick, I know I didn't show you guys, but the only thing holding the stock hood up are these two bolts to the latches. So you just remove them on each side, and then obviously removing the gas shocks. So you'll need like a flathead screwdriver to basically pry off that little cover, and it comes just right off, as you can see. And then do the same for the bottom part, which is assembled here, so it's already off. And you do the same for both sides. And this is probably the easiest install, honestly, because again, the new carbon fiber hood is just gonna mount here. The only thing missing is that this particular hood doesn't have the pre-drilled holes to use your stock gas struts. So there's actually a kit that they sell online, which I'll be installing at a later date. I just kind of didn't have it, and I've been antsy because the hood's just been sitting there at home, so I wanted to get it on. But later, we'll do a video to put those gas struts on, the aftermarket kit basically, and you guys can see what it looks like. But for now, I really don't need to do any under the hood work, so it's kind of good news. It is going to be inconvenient for a little bit. I'll probably get those ordered in the next week or so, so it's not going to be inconvenient for too long. But in the meantime, we're going to basically bolt on the new carbon fiber hood, make sure the fitment's right, and it should seal relatively easy. So yeah. All right, before you guys give me crap, this is definitely gonna be a two-man job just because the stock hood is a little heavy, so you're gonna need some help to basically take it off. And then you might even need a third person to hold it steady while you align the two bolts while you're putting it on. So what we did first was we basically installed the lower bolt. As you can see, the top bolt isn't on yet. Did the same thing for the other side right now just to kind of test fit, make sure it seats. And then once you're lined up, you're gonna put the top bolt on each side and then tighten everything accordingly. Do the typical star pattern. Again, this is carbon fiber, so be really careful not to over tighten anything. So yeah, this is a little hard to record and install just because, you know, we could really use the extra manpower, but have my pops over here helping me hold the hood up. So yeah. So the one thing is, carbon fiber is really fragile, breaks and cracks easily. So the one thing that you are going to be paranoid about as soon as you install it is, and I'm going to show you, it's on right now. So one, when you lift it up, unlike metal, it bends a little bit. So that's kind of like an issue. So you kind of want to prop it up with two hands, not one, until you get those gas shocks that I was talking about. But this is the biggest fear part, is when you set it down to lock, it's already latched there, but you feel like it's going to break. So you want to basically either fist it, two hand, whatever, and then just push it down firmly so it locks. Don't slam it, don't let it drop because it's probably gonna get damaged that way. So set it down gently, two man push until, whoa, yeah, you see that? Two man push until it locks, and that's basically
it. Don't freak out though, it's carbon fiber, you can't really dent it.
Yeah, I know, but you know, scared of breaking,
Hadouken, I'm just kidding.
Last thing you need to worry about is, again, I'm really grateful, as you guys know, I got this hood secondhand. Sure. Been out to do something about these holes that were made previously for hood pins, so let's take care of that. Oh, all right, so as always, a simple project has become something difficult. I bought aftermarket black ones to basically try to sit as flush because I don't like chrome. But the previous hood pins that were on this were obviously way big because none of these line up perfectly whatsoever. And while I probably will end up drilling new holes to basically cover the old holes, I don't want to do that right now just because I'm kind of short on time. And yeah, so in the meantime, I'm going to be ghetto and I'm going to cover up the holes with electric tape. Just put two X's on each side and call it a day for now. I know that's obviously not the optimal, but at the very least, it'll cover up the holes. So, and again, I'm working with what I've got to kind of get this going. So forgive me, guys. you know what? We'll save the drilling for the day that we also install the gas shocks. How's that? So, really happy, you know, really thankful, glad that we got the hood on. We're gonna clean it up and then kind of show you what it looks like with my little ghetto rigging. The hood just works. It's seated perfectly well. For those of you asking, this one's made by a company called Carbon Creations. So, really good fitment. Overall, really pleased.
He's just being a little extra, and it's okay. I don't blame him, because I'm the same way.
All right, while Subi Lou tries to find where one missing bolt that we found goes, which we suspect is underneath, I put black electrical tape. So from a distance, you can't really see it, so that's not too bad. It'll fix the problem for the time being. But one thing I do want to comment is, so I didn't mention, but this hood is from a company called Carbon Creations. And one of my biggest issues with it is it fits great, but the fitment isn't perfect. So you don't really have to alter anything, which is great. But here, let me show you. So my biggest cool part about it is it sits flush with, you know, the front fascia and the front grille. But as you keep on going, the gap is pretty big. Most noticeably on the driver's side, right here. Now, I won't lie to you, the stock hood that comes on these cars normally is also not perfectly aligned, so it's probably not going to bother you too much, but again, you guys know that I like transparency and I like to keep you guys informed. So this is the passenger side, and again, the gap persists here, pretty big. This part isn't so bad on the passenger side, but it does hold there. Honestly, I haven't seen any like legit reviews on the Cybon or the Viz hoods that are made for this car, so I can't really comment and say they're superior. It seems like everybody makes this typical style. The only other style really is the stock look from what I've found. But yeah, so I wanted to comment on that. Other than that, I'm really happy. I'm going to put some quick detail on to remove all the fingerprints and stuff and just kind of show you guys what it looks like. So ta-da, it's on, the vents are dirty. I'm gonna do this video real quick because it's windy and I don't want it to pick up. Finally, that sigh of relief. But look how good it looks after it got its clear cut and everything. An X marks the spot. I have something special in plan for those, so you'll just have to wait and see. But overall, we got a lot done today, so I'm really happy. So one last thing you want to do before you close off your hood is you want to remove this little nub that basically pushes down on a hood latch switch to allow you to use your alarm and lock your car. Especially for those of you guys that have the keyless entry ones, it's this little thing. It sits on the passenger side. And it goes right in here and pushes down the switch. This hood, unfortunately, even though it has a ton of holes, doesn't really have a place for this particular little sensor. So it should be somewhere on here, but again, yeah. So what you're gonna have to do is ghetto rig it. Once again, I can't speak for other carbon fiber hood companies, but what I'm gonna do is I'm basically gonna put this down and just tape it down. So that way it's constantly pressed down, so you'll be able to lock the car regardless of if the hood is fully latched or not. So yeah. And as you can see, it's completely ghetto rigged. I put the little thing down and just basically used electrical tape to seat it in there and push it all the way down. So let's see if my ghetto rigging worked. So moment of truth, setting it down. Again, being really careful. Whew! Gotta close the trunk real quick.
A day in the life of Seamus.
Let's see, please. Success! So, hood is finally installed. Fuck.
Dun, 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 dun.
FML. Yes, achievement unlocked. Take us off recording. So guys, that about wraps the carbon hood install. Short video, super easy, but it requires at least two, maybe even three people to help you out with it. You know, I'd recommend that just because it's gonna be a very hard job if you just do it by yourself. You're gonna have a hard time. Thanks, huge shout out to Subi Lou over here who's sulking or doing something, I don't know. But thank you guys so much as always for all the love and support. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Real quick, the giveaway is still going on. I'll make another video talking about that next week, but I have more exciting news regarding that giveaway, so stay tuned.